गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू योर कंप्यूटर क्लास। आई होप ऑल यू हैव परचेस्ड योर कंप्यूटर बुक। एज आई टोल्ड लास्ट डे दैट टाइम इज वेरी लेस एंड यू हैव टू स्टडी अ लॉट बिफोर योर हाफ ईयरली एग्जाम। ओनली 2 months लेफ्ट। इन आवर लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट इक्विवेलेंस लॉस। नाउ इन टूडेज क्लास वी विल लर्न द लॉजिक सर्किट्स एंड गेट्स। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। एट फर्स्ट वी विल लर्न बेसिक लॉजिक गेट्स। तो व्हाट इज लॉजिक गेट्स? A gate is simply an electronic circuit which operates on one or more input signal to produce one output signal. Gates are digital circuits because the input and output signals are either low voltage or high voltage. So low voltage is denoted by 0 and high voltage is denoted by 1. Gates are also called logic circuits because they can be analyzed with Boolean algebra. There are 3 types of basic gates: inverter gate, OR gate and AND gate. Inverter gate is also called NOT gate. So first we will learn these 3 basic gates. Inverter gate or NOT gate. An inverter is a gate with only one input signal and it produces one output signal. The output signal is always the opposite of input signal. So if input is low or zero, then it produces high output, that means 1. And if input is high or 1, then output will be low, means 0. So it just gives the opposite state of the input. This is the gate symbol, triangle bubble. From left side input is coming, and when it is going through this gate, we are getting output at the right hand side, which is complements of the input. Next is OR gate. This OR gate has 2 or more input signal, but it produces only 1 output signal. If any of the input signal is high or 1, then output signal will be high. And when both the inputs are 0 or low, it will produce the output low. See here, this is 2 inputs truth table. 0, 0 for output 0, and for all other cases it will give 1. So if any of the input is 1 or both are 1, then it will produce output 1. This is 3 inputs truth table. 0, 0, 0 for 0, in all other cases 1, because here we have either 1 input 1 or 2 inputs 1 or 3 inputs 1. In expression, OR is represented by plus symbol. So this is 2 input OR gate. How to write in expression? F is the output equal to X plus Y. X and Y, these 2 are input. Here F is output, X, Y, Z, these 3 are inputs. So this is 3 inputs expression. How to write? X plus Y plus Z. And the gate symbol is this, which we will use to design electronic circuit. 2 inputs OR gate, 3 inputs OR gate, 4 inputs OR gate. So for any number of inputs, output will be 1 only. Next, AND gate. So this is also just like OR gate. It works on 2 or more inputs but produce only 1 output signal. When all inputs are 1, it produces high output. Otherwise, output is 0. Here, this is the truth table of 2 inputs AND gate. X and Y, these 2 are input and F is output. When both inputs are 1, it produces output 1, otherwise 0. That means if any one input is 0 or both are 0, then output will be 0. And this is 3 inputs truth table. X, Y, Z, 3 inputs and F is output. Here also see 1, 1, 1. When all inputs are 1, then output is 1, otherwise 0. For 1, 0 input, output will be 0. The expression symbol of AND gate is dot, means product. X and Y means X dot Y. X and Y and Z for X dot Y dot Z. And this is what the gate symbol. 2 inputs AND gate, 3 inputs AND gate, 4 inputs AND gate. So we have learned 3 basic gates, NOT, AND and OR. Now we will learn some more gates. Those are derived from these 3 basic gates. They are NOR gate, NAND gate, XOR gate and XNOR gates. So let us learn one by one all these derived gates. So let's start with NOR gates. What is that? NOR gate. NOR gate means not OR gate. This is the inverse of OR gate or complements of OR gate. So OR gate means when all inputs are 0, output will be 0, otherwise 1. And here when all inputs are 0, output will be 1, otherwise 0. See here it is written, a NOR gate has 2 or more input signal but only 1 output signal. If all inputs are 0, then the output signal is 1 or high. When any one input is 1, it will produce the signal low, that is 0. See here 2 inputs truth table and this one is 3 inputs truth table. X and Y 2 inputs. When both the inputs are 0, then it produces output 1, high. When any one input is high, then output will be 0. Here also you see, when all inputs are 0, output will be high. If any one input is 1 or high, then output will be 0. So as this is complements of OR gate means X plus Y. So here the expression symbol is not X plus Y. This complements of X plus Y. Here complements of X plus Y plus Z.
or we can use apostrophe also after enclosing this expression x plus y plus z, or tilde symbol can also come before that bracket. Here in the gate symbol, this is OR gate followed by NOT gate. So these two can be combined. Here we can remove this triangle symbol and put that bubble after this OR gate. See, this is the actual symbol of NOR gate. Two inputs NOR gate, three inputs NOR gate, and four inputs NOR gate. Now come to this AND gate. This is also like NOR gate, but this is the complements of AND gate. Like AND gate, this also works on two or more input and produce only one output signal. If all inputs are one or high, then output will be zero. And if any one input is zero, then output will be one. See here, this is two inputs truth table. This is three inputs truth table. 0 0 for 1, 0 1 for 1, 1 0 for 1, and 1 1 for 0. So in AND gate, remember 1 1 for 1, otherwise 0, and here 1 1 for 0, and in other cases 1. Here also 1 1 1. All inputs are high means output is low, and when any one input is low, then output will be high. So AND gate was x dot y, and here the complements of x dot y. So xy bar or xyz bar means x into y into z bar. Here also we can use apostrophe or tilde symbol to specify the complements of AND gate. See here, AND gate followed by NOT gate. Here also like NOR gate, we can remove this triangle to put this bubble here after this AND gate. So this is the gate symbol. Two inputs NAND gate, three inputs NAND gate, four inputs NAND gate. Now for this OR gate, instead of this plus symbol, we can use V symbol also. So X, V, Y, V, Z. And for AND gate, we can use caret symbol or exponent symbol, x, exponent y, exponent z. And for NOR gate, we can use down arrow symbol, x, down arrow y, down arrow z. And for AND gate, up arrow symbol, x, up arrow y, up arrow z. Now XOR gate for exclusive OR gate. So this exclusive OR gate also works on two or more input signal but produce only one output signal. XOR gate produce output 1 or high for only those input combination that have odd number of 1s. So that means for odd number of 1s output will be 1, and for even number of 1 output will be 0. See, 2 inputs truth table and 3 inputs truth table. X, Y, these two are input and F is the output. 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 1 four combination using two inputs. See here 0 1 1 only 1, that means odd number of 1, output is 1. Here also 1 0 1 1, that means odd number of 1, output is 1. Here 1 1 1 three ones, that means odd number of 1, output is 1. Here also odd number of 1 because only one input is 1, output is 1. Here also one input is 1, one input is 1, so for them output is 1. In all other cases, outputs are 0. See, odd number of 1, odd number of 1, odd number of 1, odd number of 1. Here 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, and then here 3 1s. So outputs are 1. This is the gate symbol of XOR gate, exclusive OR gate. OR gate, before that one curve. 2 inputs exclusive OR gate, 3 inputs exclusive OR gate, 4 input XOR gate. An expression symbol of XOR gate is plus around that one circle. Then XNOR gate. XNOR gate is what? Exclusive NOR gate. This is actually the complements of XOR gate. In XOR gate, we have learned that odd number of 1 for output 1, here even number of 1 for output 1. See here 2 inputs truth table and this is 3 inputs truth table. Here odd number of input 1, here odd number of 1, outputs are 0. See here 3 1s, 1 1, 1 1, 1 1, these are odd number of 1 in input combination, so output is 1. And this is XNOR gate symbol. XOR followed by bubble. Bubble for NOT. So this is 2 inputs XNOR, this is 3 inputs XNOR, this is 4 inputs XNOR. And here expression symbol is not given in your book. One dot around that circle. Dot around the circle. XOR gate was plus around that circle. See, plus around the circle. And in XNOR, dot around that circle. Okay. Now using these three basic gates and four derived gates, we can design and draw any circuit. Like this is one circuit, see. F, A, B, C. F is a function. It has three inputs, A, B, and C. And this expression is the definition of the function. A dot B. A dot B means A and B. Plus means or. A dot C naught means A and C naught. Or B naught and A naught and C. So this is nothing but a sum of products. See here, this is one product term, this one is second product term, and this one is third product term. And this plus symbols are sum, means or of three AND operations. See, A AND B, or A AND NOT C, or NOT B AND NOT A AND NOT C. Has given wrong, this will be A. Now we have to draw the logic circuit for this expression. First, you have to draw three AND gates for three product terms. A, B, so A AND B, AND operation, we are getting A, B. Then to get A dot C not, A and C not. So from here, after this NOT gate, we are getting C not. So A and C not, among them AND operation, we are getting the product term A C not. And last is B not A not C. So B, from B we are getting B not, from A we are getting A not using this NOT gate, and C directly we are taking. Then this three input will go through this AND gate, and we will get this product term B not A not C. And then the output of this three AND gate will be used as input for the last OR gate, which will give the sum of these three product terms. That will be AB plus AC not plus B not A not C. Let's take another example. Function F has three inputs X, Y and Z. And the definition is the expression X plus Y dot X not plus Z not dot Y plus Z. So here first you have to find out three sum terms and then their product. First sum term is X plus Y. So X plus Y means OR gate. X and Y two inputs for OR gate, and it is producing the output X plus Y. The next one is X not plus Z not. That means from X and Z we have to find out their complements. So we are using NOT gates. From X we are getting X not here. From Z we are getting Z not here. Then these two outputs we will use here as input for OR gate to get the sum of X not plus Z not. And last one is Y plus Z, that means Y or Z. See here. Then these three sum terms we will use here as input for AND gate. And AND gate is giving the product of these sum terms, that is X plus Y into X not plus Z not into Y plus Z. So this way we can design any circuit. It's very easy. Go through the study material which I have given and try to solve the exercise of chapter 2.
So today up to this much, we will not learn much from this chapter. The part which is left, that we will learn after half yearly, because that is there in our annual portion. In our next class, we will start Java. Till then, bye, have a nice day.